Hello everyone, in this video I am going to give a detailed line by line analysis of William Blake's famous poem A Poison Tree. William Blake is acknowledged to be the first major English romantic poet. He was born on 28th November 1757. The poem A Poison Tree is included in his famous work Songs of Experience, published in 1794. His other great work include Songs of Innocence, which was published in 1789. In the Songs of Innocence, he shows a kind of existence which is full of joy and harmony, whereas in Songs of Experience, there is a sense of gloom and mystery. Before going for the line-by-line description of the poem, I'd like to give you guys some information about the poem. To start with, the poem is a sort of fable in verse. Now let me discuss briefly for those who do not know what a fable is. A fable is a simple story with a deep moral meaning underneath it. Though The Poison Tree comes across as a very simple poem, but it is much more than that. The poem bears out Blake's serious vision of human sin and suffering. Now we will begin with the line-by-line discussion of the poem. A Poison Tree. I was angry with my friend. I told my wrath did end. I was angry with my foe, I told it not, my wrath did grow. In the first line of the poem itself, the poet declares that once he was angry with his friend. I told my wrath did end. The meaning of wrath here is the feeling of anger. So, the speaker told his friend about the reason of his anger, and his anger died down, as it was given an outlet. I was angry with my foe, I told it not, my wrath did grow. So in the second instance, we can find that the speaker was again angry with his foe, but this time he chose not to tell his foe about his feeling of anger, and thereby his anger grew. Thus the speaker at the first instance gave his anger an outlet, and as a result he was reconciled to his friend again. But in the second instance, he suppressed his feeling of anger inside himself, which made him more and more angry. And I watered it in fears, night and morning with my tears. Here we can find an imagery related to gardening. Just as a plant need water to grow, the fear about the reaction of his foe upon hearing his true feelings made the speaker conceal his wrath, which led to the growth of resentment against his foe. He shed tears of suppressed vengeance throughout day and night. And I sunned it with smiles and with soft, deceitful wiles. Sunned it means warmed, whereas soft, deceitful wiles refers to the cunning tricks that the speaker secretly thought about. Here, the speaker tells us that he faked friendship with his foe by suppressing his vengeful passions under the cover of warm and friendly smile. He behaved as if there is nothing wrong between his foe and himself, but deep inside, he devised cunning tricks to bring about the destruction of his foe. And it grew both day and night, till it bore an apple bright. Now what does this it mean? If we go by the title of the poem, then it used here refers to the poison tree that grew both day and night. But if we delve deeper into the meaning of the poem, then we can figure out that the it which is used here actually refers to the suppressed wrath of the speaker. So, the suppressed wrath of the speaker grew continuously. It grew both day and night, till it bore an apple bright, till it gave birth to a bright and beautiful apple. Here, the external beauty of the apple is used as a stark contrast to the poisonous interior of the apple. Every one of us know the proverb that all that glitters is not gold. And in this case also, the exterior beauty of the apple is used as a bait to catch the prey. In this context, the symbol of the apple definitely alludes to the story of the fall of Adam and Eve from the Garden of Eden. According to the story of Milton's Paradise Lost, God forbade Adam and Eve to taste from the forbidden tree of knowledge. But they fell prey to the lure of the bright fruit of forbidden tree, leading to the eternal suffering and the fall of man from heaven. In Paradise Lost, just as Satan tempts Eve to eat from the forbidden tree of knowledge, Here also the speaker tempts his foe to eat the bright apple of the poison tree. And my foe beheld it shine, and he knew that it was mine. His foe was mesmerized by the shine of the apple. He was jealous of the prized possession that the speaker had, and so he decides to take it away from the speaker. And into my garden stole. Here stole means to sneak in secretly without taking permission. When the knight had wheeled the pole. Wheeled the pole refers to the fact that the night was so dark that even the pole star could not be seen. So his foe came in secretly into his garden when the darkness of the night had covered the pole star. If we look carefully here, we can find that the night has been personified. The night is doing something. It is covering the pole. In the morning glad I see my foe outstretched beneath the tree. In the morning the speaker was glad. Here glad means happy. The speaker was glad to find his foe dead beneath the poison tree. The word glad used here show the speaker's pathetic mental state. To be glad on seeing someone dead is inhuman. The speaker is so much blinded by his wrath that he comes across as a man without any human feeling or compassion. Wrath, like all other emotions, is natural and must be given vent to. When it is suppressed or concealed, it poisons the whole mind and leads to dangerous consequences. Thus, the poison tree or the suppressed wrath not only destroys one's enemy, but it also leads to self-destruction. Thank you guys for listening to this poem. I hope that you guys have understood the poem. Do like and share my videos and let me know if you have any doubts regarding this poem.